Hey, Lewis Turner here for Guitar Interrupted magazine, back with another review. And in this particular review, I'm taking a look at this amp here from Vox, the Vox AC4. So this is part of their range. There's three in the range. There's a 4-watt, which is the one we've got here, 15-watt and a 30-watt one. So obviously just the 4-watt one is the smallest one in the range. And as you can see, it looks fantastic, and we'll go through some of the features of it and show you some of the different sounds. So just give you a little bit of history. These amps first appeared back in the 1960s, and these coloured amps first appeared back in the 1960s, were massively popular, and now they've been replicated for the modern day, and every detail, supposedly, has been meticulously replicated, which we'll find out. So first things first, I think we agree it looks great if you're into these kind of retro looking amps. Looks a bit like one of those old radios, but it looks fantastic. Finish throughout is top notch. You know, all the two-tone colours and all the binding and everything looks great. So it really stands out as a decent bit of kit. So the sound you heard there was a kind of everything at level, and then we'll try some different ones and see what we can get. So the controls on this amp are at the top here, which hopefully we can see. So it's a very, very simple setup. It's a valve amp powered by two 12 AX7 tubes for the preamp, and a 10-inch Celestion speaker, so that's it, simple as that. And we've just got a few simple controls at the top to get all the different sounds that we want out of it. So, starting from left to right, we have one input, a gain control, bass control, treble, volume, your on-off switch, and the power indicator light. Nice little handle, and this is your vent for the heat to escape from the tubes. So very simple setup. So what can we get from this? Well, as you can see from the levels I've got here, this is what you heard at the start. So I'll play around with a few others. So if I wanted a very clean sound, I could obviously back the gain down and then just bring my volume up. Remember, we're only at 4 watts, so it's quite a small output amp. So this is my clean sound. We haven't got any reverb or anything on. It's just purely you're hearing the amp setting. I'll level everything off. So this would be a clean sound. So pristine clean, absolutely perfect, and that was the gain up just a very small amount. If we wanted to crunch it up ever so slightly, kind of a country rock sound, it works great for that. And so the thing that makes little valve amps very popular and in high demand is going back to that 1960s sound. What they used to do was just turn everything up on max to those tones you heard then with the valves working at their hardest. And try as they might, solid state amps, as good as they are, can never truly replicate that sound. So if we're literally pushing the valves to their limit, it gives you that broken up sound, you know. That's what Hendrix was notorious for. Those big, even his rhythm sounds were quite dirty, but it was just valve amp dirtiness, wasn't any kind of effects in the loop. So that's why little valve amps are great, because you can turn them up. You know, inherently valve amps are very, very loud, so if you get like a 40 or a 50 watt one, even on volumes 2 or 3, they really take your head off. So with the smaller ones, you can really push them, mic them up, and you get that kind of broken up sound, which is what we started to get there. And the gain control on here also helps that along a lot more. So if I started to push the gain up and bring the volume back down a little bit, you hear that crunchiness starting to come through, and get the kind of bluesy sound. Thank you. Nice indeed. Very warm sounding amp. Sounds great. And let's just see, for the sake of it, if we pushed it all the way, what we can get from that. Fair bit of gain then, I can push the volume right up as well. And you can see that we've got plenty of power there, so even in a little venue with a good mic and a good PA, or if you're just out, you know, playing by yourself, self-accompanying a singer or something, this could be perfect for you. Very simple EQ setup, just a bass and treble. Some might argue it's lacking a mid control, would have been nice, three band EQ, but it's not a big deal, we can get plenty of the tones we want. So let's just see what difference it makes here. If I roll the bass right up, should be able to get a nice, warm, bassy sound. If I match that with the guitars, tone down as well. Get a very old school sound, which is cool. If we want something a little bit more cutting, then we could bring the bass down and roll the treble back up. Etc. So there's lots of variety just having a treble and a bass control in here. Around the back, you can obviously use the speaker that it's connected to, or you can do a line out feed and power it to a larger speaker, so we can still use the controls we got here and then send it if you wanted to, I know, a 4x12 or something like that, and see different sounds you can get from that. So a very versatile little amp, completely portable. The size of it is perfect for traveling around with. So do a little bit more playing, play around with some different sounds, see what we can get out of it. So in that short time there, we went from very clean sound up to a kind of bluesy crunch into quite a saturated lead sound. So very versatile, sounds great. Hopefully you're getting the sound through the other in there. Sounds very authentic, sounds very small valve ampish, which clearly it is. So if you're looking for something quite portable, something you can turn up loud and start to get that breaking up sound and something that looks absolutely fantastic, then this Vox AC4 could well be the amp for you. You should also go and check out the other two in the range, the 15 watt and the 30 watt, if you require something a little bit more power. But definitely go and give one a try for yourself. It gets a thumbs up from me. Thanks for watching.